Yes, and the fact is, you know, you were talking about A.K. Mishra, the economic aspects. Okay. Yes, Mr. Mishra.
Yeah, actually, one thing in very challenging manner, I just would like that, what are the economic importance of, you can say, the Hindu temple as well as the Sikh, or you can say the India or religion and their religious places. You see, our forefathers, they were not foolish. They had developed, they were investing 20 year, 30 year, 50 year for building a temple. And so many, you can say, the investment fund and money, it was invested. And you can say the worker, artists, they were called, they were invited, some of the finest. They were not foolish. They have created all these temples purposefully. The first important thing what I wanted to say, especially in concern of, in relation of Pakistan, whatever debt problem they are facing, they just opened Sharda Peeth and you can say the places related with the Sikhism and Katacheshwar Nath Mandir, and provide security, guarantee the security for Indian pilgrims. Whatever the money will be generated, it will be sufficient to bring out Pakistan from financial crisis. This is one. Second important thing, we have already, you can say that we are listening it, that India, especially in terms of for our country, that you can say by unity in diversity, what is this concept? You see our forefather, how philanthropist they were, how intellectual they were. They were knowing that in India, so many different kind of languages as well as you can say the culture, it is available. It was very much difficult that in such a diverse environment to bind each and every person. You just see the example, even few days back, there was the, you can say the protest, especially in Karnataka, that was politically motivated, that we don't want Hindi, we are not welcoming Hindi people. But you, if you go 1,000 years back, there is no such a conflict was there. Why a person living in Kashi is thinking that Rameshwaram, it is also mine place? Why Shankaracharya, born in Kerala and visited to North India, and in Prayagraj, he made the Shastrarth with Mandan Mishra and then traveled to the Kashi? He was having each and everything sufficient in Kerala also, but he traveled across the country and developed as well as established so many, you can say, the religious places. Dhamma, Matha, and all these things. They were very wiseful. Temples not only playing, you can say, the role in economic integrity, emotional bonding, no matter your language may be different, your fooding, because of I have traveled across India. But whenever, even in South Indian temples, so many North Indian people are going, you just visit to Prayagraj as well as so many other Kumbh Mela places, you will find not only Indian, Hindus, or you can say the Sikhism, they are also Sikh, they are also coming there and living there for 1 month, as well as you can say the Bodh, Jainism, so many people, each and every, especially India born religion, they are coming. They are coming not only for, you can say, the making holiday, they are coming for spiritual purpose. And whenever a person is coming to any religious places, he is a source for generating income for all small shopkeepers, rickshawala, hotel wala, you can say the so many other local product, whatever. See, one, especially in UP, Yogi government, they have targeted that one district, one product. In each and every state, nearby, in each and every temple, go to the Jagannath Puri, go to the Kashi Vishwanath, go to the Rameshwaram, any small temple, you will find some special kind of the product, or you can say the any kind of the cloth related, or you can say the representing particularly the culture as well as the historical or religious aspect of that temple, it is available on sale, and people are going to purchase, because of, if any person is going to Rameshwaram from Varanasi, he knows that only once in a life he will be come.
A.K. Mishra, political analyst, is also live with us on the broadcast. A.K. Mishra, which are the important temples in Karnataka for you, which need to be preserved, conserved, and what is the significance of this for the state?
See, actually, not from current, from past, if we analyze, temples, they were always epicenter for the economic growth, equal redistribution of the wealth in cumulative way created by nations, by different parties or different companies. in today it is more and more important, not only the big temple, whatever small temples are there, they are it will be good if we are going to preserve them. Because of that, you see, what is the economic condition of India? Okay, nation's economy, that's good. After that, you can say state GDP, then city as well as the villages. So a small temple, whatever it has been ignored, they play a very vital role for cultural binding. This is one thing. People, they used to come, they used to visit on fixed days, and they communicate there as well as the economic manner. So here, if we are saying that only the big temple needs for taking care, it is not. Each and every temple, because of this is related with, this is a binding force of our mentality, our psychology, as well as our cultural, you can say, the pride. So every temple, small, big, not only in Karnataka, I am talking for India as well as the abroad. As well as the abroad, say, you take example, why we are going to talk about the Sharda Pit, why we renovated the, you can say, the Kasi Vishwanath as well as the Mahakal Ujjain. So mostly I have seen that the political leaders or political party, especially you can say the opposition, they are not able to understand that what the temple and how the temple contributed in our history, in our economy. If India was or were known as, you can say, the golden bird, it was due to the, because of the temple were in the epicenter of our society, governing the economy and so many other things. Especially South India, Karnataka, they are the hub for temple as well as the so many other, you can say, the type of the dynamics, social dynamics, economic dynamics. It is motivated or governed directly or indirectly by the temple and the rituals which is going to be practices on daily basis in the temple. Direct or indirect type of the, you can say, the income generation as well as the employment generation, it is going to be done by the temple. So saying this, especially in case of India, if anybody is ignoring, saying that we are secular party, we don't believe in temple and all these things, we can't focus over the temple. Okay, you can't focus over the temple, then why you are going to provide, you are declaring Hajj subsidy as well as the, you can say, the reservations for Muslims on religious basis, as well as so many other religious activities. Government is going to fund, you can say, the pension or you can say salary for mullah and maulvis in Delhi by AAP government. One side you are saying, especially abandon the temple, rest of other religion as well as you can say the other religious places, government is going to provide aid and different kind of the support. But whenever temple is there, 80%, that is the center for the faith of 80%. You name out me any person from North India, they will not go South India for any other purpose. Every North Indian is going by means of traveling 3000 kilometer Rameshwaram, from Kashi to Rameshwaram. The factor, or you can say the motivating force that behind this immigration or migration, travel and tourism, that is religious tourism. Whatever any party leader is saying that we want to make Karnataka or India as a religious hub. One more example I would like to provide you. What is the reason why there were the battle between, in past history, between, in you can say, the Saudi Arabia and the Turkey? That was also a religious place. And that was not only for this religious place, because of the historic importance, emotional importance and economic importance, especially in Saudi Arabia, when there were no discovery of oil, most of the economy, it was revolving around that Makkah and Medina. They are also understanding, entire world, they are understanding that what are the economic and social benefit, or you can say the role of religious places. Then why in our country we are always going to ignore all the religious places? No development, no fund.
Yes, and the fact is, you know, you were talking about A.K. Mishra, the economic aspects.